Have you ever wanted to put a stereo in your car, but you didn't want to have a stereo? Does that even make sense? In today's situation here, the Y2K world we live in, having an AM/FM CD player, you might say, or whatever, is pretty much obsolete. Because everything works off your phone now. You got Pandora radio, you got XM radio, you got AM/FM radio channels and talk radios, and all these are apps that you can download on your phone and listen to those. So I was looking at my Volkswagen, and I was thinking to myself, I want to put a radio in there because I'm tired of going down the road and driving my bug, and there's no music in it. And when I bought the car, if you look over in the corner over there, it had some speakers. All right, it has these kicker panel speakers, these homemade jobs, which I'm going to be taking out. But then I decided somebody cut the hole in the fucking dash and cut it way too big, so I had to make this metal cover. I popped it up in there. You know, this is a rat rod. It really doesn't give a shit what it looks like. And I went ahead and added a lighter outlet so I can charge my phone up. And then I was going to go ahead and use this Bluetooth speaker right here as my sound system in my car. And then, of course, I was going to use my phone to Bluetooth to this speaker. And then that's what we were going to do. And I had a, if you notice right here, you can put like a tripod situation on it. And it comes with this clamp that you can buy. And then I was going to make a bar and clamp the speaker in the car and all this other crap. And then I thought, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and investigate the situation before I do all this. Because I think there's something better out there that I can do.
Welcome to DIY Automotive School. With my friend Pete and Minnie, the body shop girl. It's everything you need to know about cars and more.
So I started investigating the real deal, and what happened is I came across a system that is not a radio, but what it is, it's a 500 watt amplified Bluetooth system that you can use your phone with, or your MP3 player. It has an auxiliary input if you want to put an MP3 player in it, or whatever you want to use that can be Bluetooth compatible as a stereo system. Let's go look at that and see what we got. And hopefully this thing is going to work out for me and do the job that I want it to do. So if you look right here, you can see this is called the Boss Marine ASK902B.6. It's a Bluetooth amplifier and speaker system. It does not have an AM/FM radio. It does not have a CD player. It doesn't have anything. All it is a compatible Bluetooth system that you can use your iPad, iPod, or iPhone or whatever. If you have a that other kind of phone, you can use that on it. And it also has, and this is what I was looking at mostly, let me get over here to the back side, and we're going to also look at this in detail. It also comes with this little feature right here. We're going to take it out of the box, but I want to show you that. All right, this little situation here, and it has a USB port and also an auxiliary inlet or outlet, auxiliary interface that you can use. So while you're using your phone with this system right here, and you can see that it says Bluetooth, this, that, and the other, you can actually plug it in to this thing right here, and it's charging your phone up or your iPad or whatever you're using through the USB port. It's a 1-amp charger system through the amplifier. Let's go ahead and open this thing up and see what we got and go from there. And I just want to tell everybody, even though it says Boss Marine on here, you can use this system on basically anything. If you got some custom Harley Davidson motorcycle out there, you know, you can probably use this on there, but we're going to go through it. So when we first open the box up, what we got is a limited warranty situation. Are we really going to use that warranty? Are you really going to take this thing and ship it back to the manufacturer? That's just a scam as far as I'm concerned to say, hey, looky what we got here. We got a fucking warranty. Comes with the manual, instructional manual, quick installation guide. Okay, of course it comes with that. Of course it comes with that. Then we get this little packet here, and I guess this is a waterproof package for your phone if you are going to use it anywhere besides in a car. And I guess that's a nice system that they give you that. So then once we get past all the paperwork and the bullshit nonsense, let's go ahead and pull this out and see what this is. And this looks like a clamp that you would use on a motorcycle. And I'm speculating and guessing that that is probably for our remote control system that we can control the whole unit. And yes, it is for that. You can see there's some screws on the back. It would screw like that. So this would be a good thing, like if you have an ATV, a motorcycle, probably a Razorback 4x4 situation, and you wanted to mount this on there. There you go, right there. So I like that deal. And then speaking of our remote access, it comes with the remote, and this is a mountable situation. It's got a flush mount face here if you want to cut it out and custom mount it. And I want to show you that. Okay, and that's probably what we're going to do with it. If you look right here on the edge of it, it's got these little tabs, and that's for when you cut your metal dash out or whatever you're using, it will pop right in there and it'll stay. So I like that deal that it's got that instead of having to glue it on. I'm feeling the buttons, and they have a velvet felt feel to them. They're rubber, and also looking very closely, you can see that this is airtight, waterproof. So yeah, that's even another situation. And then of course you got your 20-foot cable that will reach all the way from front to back, inside and out. Bam, bam, thank you, ma'am. Long enough to go down the road and say, there you go. So then, once we look at that, we go ahead and open up our item here. We're going to take this cover off here, and I see that it's packed very well. I like the way that they have it packed in the styrofoam, and we're going to go ahead and take our amplifier out. We're going to take a look at that. Let me get this over here. And the amplifier looks like it's a nice, solid, sturdy amplifier. It looks like it's built well, and we're going to open it up and see what we got. So as we look at our amplifier, it's a compact amplifier. It's very sturdy, solid. It's a 4-channel Bluetooth power amplifier. This is MC900B unit, as you can see right there. And then on the back of the unit, it basically has the wiring diagram of how it all wires up. In case you just happen to throw your instructions away, you always got this as a reference to go by. And then over here, we got our RC plug-ins. Here is where our auxiliary plugs into our power unit, which would be this right here. So this plugs into this, which would make all that work. And then over here, we have another USB port, and we're gonna find out what that's for here in a few minutes. Oh, that's our charger. That's another charger system. So if you don't use the other piece that I'm gonna show you, it also has this for a charging system as well. So I like that idea too. And then it comes with all of our mounting screws and a fuse that looks like a 15 amp fuse. And then it comes with our main wire harness, which plugs into the amplifier right here, as you can see there. And then of course you would wire it all up. Very self-explanatory, battery, ground, ignition. And then, of course, your four speakers that you're going to hook up if you're going to use four speakers. And then this here, right here, is our fuse holder in case it goes short on us. It won't mess our electrical system up. And yes, very, very common, simple, easy to understand situation. And then we got another box right here. Let's go ahead and open this up. And this is the item that I really wanted to see right here. I'm going to open that up and look at it, because this is the situation that says this is pretty awesome. It's got all these fittings here, and it's kind of like a lighter. All right, so you would drill out your hole, and I'm believing that's about a 1 1/8 inch hole, possibly a 1 inch to a 1 1/8 inch. You would go ahead and use a hole saw on that, stuff your wires through, and then it also comes with all these adapters here that screw onto there. One would be for a self-leveling type nut. Then this one here would be our lock nut. And then, of course, this would go on top of here first. So we would have a cover on it that would cover it basically just like that when it's not in use. But I want you to pay close attention to this system. This is the selling point right here. It's got an auxiliary in case you want to hook up an MP3 player, a little memory player, or you can hook up right here, and this would also be a charging unit for the unit if you didn't want to use this one right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mount this on my dash next to my lighter outlet, and then I'll be able to be charging up my phone while I'm listening to it on my Bluetooth amplified system. Very, very awesome. I like this, and you're not going to believe the price, so just hang on a second. Now that we've looked at the unit and all the accessories that it comes with, let's go ahead and check out these speakers. These are supposed to be waterproof, airtight speakers. Comes with enough wire here to run it wherever you want. The gauge of the wire looks pretty thick, and it's also color-coded. I like that. It also comes with a mounting kit. All right, it comes with the little tabs right here, and then also the four screws we're going to need to put it all together. And then as we get our speakers out, these are a 6.5 inch, and I'm going to guess that these are not triaxial but coaxial. Comes with some type of a gasket, wow, for vibration, I believe. And then, of course, here we go right here. Here's our speaker. It's a waterproof speaker inside and out. It's specifically designed for in the water use, marine speaker. You can see it's a dual cone speaker. Here's our tweeter in the middle, subwoofer, bass, whatever you want to call it, on the outside. And it's all enclosed and encased just like you see it. The cover does not come off separately, and it looks like a very, very nice high quality. It says it's 180 watts, 4 ohms. And this system here is going to probably be more than enough that I need for my little Volkswagen. So now that we went over the system thoroughly and I showed you everything that it's got, the real question is how much is this thing? That's the real question. What's our price on that, my friend Pete, on the Marine Boss unit, the ASK902B-.6 Bluetooth amplifier and speaker system? What is the price on that? I have an account over at a wholesale dealer where I buy my stereo parts, and they sold this to me for $89.95 plus tax. It came to approximately a little bit under $100, and I saw them. Did I tell you this was 500 watt max power? Pretty nice. But I saw them on eBay for $125, and then I also researched the internet, other places that are selling it, and it was all the way up to $325. So you can get this on eBay for $125, and I believe it's free shipping, and it's well worth the money. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and install this system in my car, and then once I get it all installed, we're going to come back and listen to it and see what it sounds like. So we'll be back on the Boss Marine ASK902B-6. As we don't give you just a box opening and show you something that we don't hook up, but we actually hook the motherfucker up and give you a 100% fucking review if it's worth a shit, if it's not, or if it's just a mediocre item and, you know, it gives you some fucking sound. There's a lot of videos out there that do these opening box videos. I'm gonna open it up and show it to you. My friend Pete takes it one more step and goes all the fucking way. We'll be back. All right, we just got done hooking up our Boss Bluetooth system. Let me grab my flashlight here. We're gonna look at that, show you how easy it is to hook up. And if you look right there, it's basically like hooking up any stereo system that you got, just basic. You got your two speaker wires. Make sure that you put those on the plus and the minus, just like it shows in the directions of the speakers, to get the right output and the best quality. You got your ignition wire, which is the yellow one. And then if you trace that there, I've got two hands busy here. The red one is the ignition, yellow one is battery. And then this is a plug and play deal right here, which hooks up our remote control. and also our USB port. And then the whole brain of the situation is right there, the amplifier itself, and that's basically it. Now, they do have the four-speaker system. We only got the two-speaker system. That's all we're going to need. You can see by the directions right here, very easy, very simple hookup. And let's get in the car. Let's see what this thing does as we try out our Boss Bluetooth power amp system. This is a four-channel with two speakers. I got the two-speaker instead of the four-speaker and see what's going on. So let's go ahead and start with our speakers. You can see where I mounted my speakers, right next to the door on the kicker panel. They fit really well. I like where they fit, and I think they're going to work pretty good. Now, keep in mind, these are waterproof speakers. They're actually specifically designed for boat use, so I don't know really what the quality of the sound's going to be, but I haven't played it yet. Now, I did go ahead and sync it up with our Bluetooth system on our iPhone, and this also works with Android phones, not just your iPhone. So let's go ahead and turn it on and see what we got in the 1967 Rat Rod Bug with our Bluetooth stereo system called Boss. Alright, so here's our remote control system. I went ahead and mounted mine on my dash, and then of course we got the USB auxiliary, which is right here, which is also a charging port, a 1 amp charging port to charge your phone up or whatever you're charging. And then we're also going to try to use our MP3 player with our unit. I don't have the auxiliary cord, so we're going to try to use it with the USB cord and see if that works. But let's go ahead and do the Bluetooth first. What I did is I took my iPhone, I went ahead and synced it to this. Then you go to your settings, and then you're going to find the MC900B, all right, and then you're going to go ahead and connect it. So it says it's not connected now. Let's go ahead and turn the key on. And then we're going to hit the power button, which is the SRC. And we're going to hold that in, and it's going to turn blue just like you see right there. And let's go ahead and hook it up. Okay, it just connected. I don't know if you heard that. It makes a dinging noise. So it is now connected. We're going to go ahead and click out of that. And I'm going to go ahead and use Pandora Radio. I got it hooked up already. We're going to go ahead and use Pandora and see what happens. Pandora is a free radio system. If you want to pay for it, you can. But I got my volume up all the way on the phone, and I believe that this is a volume control right here. And then you got your play, pause, and then back and forth. So let's go ahead and see what happens. And that is now working off of the Bluetooth of my phone. So, like I said, I got the volume all the way up here. Let's go ahead and turn the volume up on the system and see what it sounds like. So, the deal we got is it works pretty good. I like the system. It's got a separate volume here, and also you can control it by your phone itself. Let's go ahead and try that. So, we'll turn it up there. Then we're going to come to the volume here, and you can see it works with your phone as well. And then what I want to do is I'm going to go ahead, and I haven't read the directions on this, so I don't know if this is going to work, but we're going to go ahead and plug this in here, which is our USB. We can get it in there. There it is. And then I see that it is coming on. You can see where it's powering up, and let's see if it'll play once it's on. Okay, we're back with our Boss unit, our MP3/Bluetooth unit that we were doing a review on. And remember when the unit was turning red and it wasn't doing anything, and we had our MP3 player plugged in and we couldn't figure it out? Well, we found out what the red was for. The red is actually when you're using your auxiliary port and you want music. So we got the red on. Let's go ahead and see if this is on. Okay. So that's what that's for. Let's go ahead and click that off. When it's in red mode, I don't know if you can see red on there. You can barely see it, but it is red. That is for auxiliary and your USB port. And then the blue, if we click it again, you can see it turn blue. That would be for your Bluetooth unit, which would be your phone. So the red, we're going to hit it once. The red is for our MP3 player, just like that.
I'd like to have it start.
And then if you were using your phone, you'd click it again and it would turn blue. And then of course, if you got some type of a unit that will work through the USB port, that would also work as well. And you can go down the road and everybody's happy. So this is actually a good unit. I just thought I'd show you that. I went back and I investigated the situation, and that is what the situation is. The situation is, it's a good deal. And if you aren't looking to have a stereo in your car and you're going to be using your iPhone a lot, this is the unit for you. So if you're in the market for a Bluetooth stereo system for your car and you don't want to hassle with high-tech, very expensive and exotic stereo systems, I believe this is a good situation right here. It's the ASK902B.6, and that's made by Boss, and it's actually a marine item. They say that it's a marine for the boat system. Everything is waterproof and works great. What are we gonna do with this? Probably not a motherfucking thing. Maybe give it to somebody that actually owns a boat and let them have it. So there you go. One more time, the Boss Marine. It's a thumbs up on this situation. I like the product. I think it's awesome. And it's also 500 watts maximum power. Now I will show you one more thing I did. I went ahead and painted my speakers black. I took some flat black cheap acrylic spray paint fucking quick drying shit, and I went ahead and sprayed a coat of black, flat black, charcoal black paint on them, and it actually looks better in my car than if they were white. So there you go. That is the full review on this deal, and if you're interested in one, get on eBay and look for them. They're about $125 free shipping, and well worth the money. I really like this unit. This is all I wanted. And it sounds awesome. Take it easy. We'll see you later. Boss, all the way.
School. Classes don't stop till you know everything.